I was born in Wellesley, Massachusetts in 1935. Wellesley is a suburb of Boston. And my father was a teacher in the high school in Wellesley for many years, sort of much beloved, goodbye Mr. Chip sort of teacher. And my mother was a housewife until my brother and I didn't have to be looked at all the time, and then she became a librarian in a town, not Wellesley, but nearby where we had moved when I was in the third grade. And I grew up in a perfectly ordinary, I don't know quite what the word is, shabby, genteel, something, whatever, not genteel, no, but I mean, on the pay of a high school teacher, but perfectly nice, you know, solid family. And I was of an age where there was no television when I was young, and movies were everything as far as any sort of visual information or entertainment went. And even when I was a small child in Wellesley, there, for some reason, the Wellesley school system had Wednesday afternoons off, and just little children, I'm amazed that they, was a more innocent age, I guess, let us take the bus. We took the bus down to Wellesley Hills to the Colonial Theatre and saw movies that for children on Wednesday afternoons. And then when we moved to Sherburne, I took the bus every Saturday afternoon just about to, Sherburne was a tiny little country town without anything. But we took the bus to Framingham, which was the large town nearby where there were three theaters and where every Saturday afternoon there were westerns and various things for kids. And I was devoted to movies as a child, as all the other children were, because there was no television. We could listen to serials like Captain Midnight on the radio, but for anything really exciting, we had to see movies, and there was a whole culture of children going to movies and movies aimed at children, really small children. Abbott and Costello movies and westerns and things like that, almost all in black and white, and almost all be considered, you know, just barely B movies now, in terms of price and production and all that. And also, I only have only recently realized what an influence they must have been on me, also newsreels. I was reading a book where Godard was talking about newsreels, and I realized how much newsreels probably meant to me. Because in those days, they were almost always shot on, they were all black and white, but they were almost always shot in 35 millimeter. You know, the IMO was the combat camera of the Second World War in the United States, and it was a 35 millimeter camera. So they were really beautiful, big negatives and amazing footage, because the newsreels when I was a child were the Second World War. So there would be, you know, airplanes flying and bombs exploding and battleships firing huge cannons and things, and they were extraordinarily powerful images of a world far away from Wellesley or Sherburne, Massachusetts, but and far more engrossing and powerful. I mean, what seemed like the real world, and they must have had a vast influence on my thinking about movies, I think, and I didn't realize that until many years later, but they certainly did, as did Abbott and Costello and the Westerns and all the things we saw as children. But I didn't have any idea that movies were made by ordinary mortals like myself, you know, that you could, a little boy from Massachusetts could go and make movies, and it never even occurred to me, nor did it occur to me years later when I was more or less grown up.